Alright, moving on. I decided not to make another pressure flaker yet. I don't really need the super fine detailing yet. I mean, I'm getting pretty close to that, but I just gave this a little sharpen for now. What I want to do is try and take my last few indirect flakes and then get set up for a whole bunch of pressure flaking. Oops. That'll have to be enough. I can pressure flake the rest of that off later. For now, I just want to get these high spots and ridges down. Again, I kind of angled that a little bit too far that way, but that's okay. Getting a really thin base now. Oops. Yep. The last bunch of work on any point is always very tedious. You know, lots of pressure flaking and shaping and getting things just right, at least for me anyways. That's my process. I'm not gonna speed up these videos at all. I used to do that a little bit, but I don't really like doing that anymore. Yeah, I need to try and angle it more across this time and not towards the tip or, you know, towards the right. Sorry if I'm, you know, bleeding on camera here. I've got dry skin at the end of the winter here. Trying to moisturize. It'll be better soon. Well enough. I was debating whether or not to take an indirect flake there, but I didn't want to risk it so late in the game, so I opted for a larger pressure flake. That worked out pretty well. There's a couple weird little step fractures going on in the tip here, so I just gotta rework that a little bit. I'm gonna try and, you know, turn the tip into its almost final version. Do the final shaping and thinning work closer to the end. I'm just trying to smooth out this ugly scar as much as I can. I'm gonna try and get another indirect flake soon. think I can catch the edge of my punch right on this small platform. Get across here. And then I'm gonna start coming from the other side, the other edge. Perfect. Didn't want to hit that too hard. Just wanted to follow that ridge. This is kind of what I wanted to do originally when I ended up making this bad scar. I'm gonna leave that for now. I'll probably end up reworking the edge a little bit later, but for now you can see which part of this is out of the profile. This is my high spot. I need to bring it in to here, so maybe I'll start down here, take some flakes this way. Long video already. Feel like I've hardly done anything. That's how it goes in the pressure flaking stage. These later stages, it always feels like everything's moving so slowly. But with this work, it's more important to be accurate and, you know, careful. So, as the tortoise and the hare said, you know, slow and steady wins the race. An interesting flake. Worked out really well. I really have not been watching the camera much, so I hope this has all been on in frame. Beauty. If I can just keep doing that all the way down here, I might be able to balance things out in the end. Battery's low again, as always. 23 minutes now, okay. I'm gonna need to wrap this up soon. I wanna try and get two more flakes, I think. Slowly but surely getting rid of these high spots, creating an okay flaking pattern in the process. Slipped a little bit there. Thank you. smaller the piece gets, the harder it gets to hold and stabilize this properly, just with, I generally just have it like this so that I'm not exerting pressure on one point in the middle and snap it. Need to get this sitting just right. High angle, high speed. Whoa. Too much in the wrong direction, but well, that almost dove right down in the middle of that thing too. Risky. How did I have that angle so wrong? Oh well. Well, I need to get this pressure flaker resharpened and get myself resorted out here. One more flake, maybe. Maybe I should just do pressure with that. It's getting real thin there. Yeah, I don't think I'm ever gonna get this turned into a piece that I'm 100% happy with, but as long as I can get it finished with a decent, somewhat decent overall, you know, Dalton size, shape, edge morphology, base. It doesn't need to have a perfect flaking pattern. It would have been nice, but I'll try for my 1,000 subscriber giveaway to get that nice ribbon flaking pattern on something. slowly but surely, this thing is taking some sort of shape. Like I said, it's a long process, but that's quitting time for the night. I'll try and get some more work done on it tomorrow or the next day. Got character, that's for sure. Well, if you want to win this piece, please like and comment on one of these videos. The 500 subscriber chert, Georgetown chert videos, which this is part 7 of so far, with probably at least 2 more parts to go. Some heavy duty pressure flaking. You also need to subscribe to the channel. I've had 17 more subscribers since I started, since I announced the giveaway. It's only been a couple weeks, so that's pretty awesome. Thanks everyone for that. Last video I said I'd start getting some names into the pottery for the draw, but I haven't done that yet, obviously. Anyways, I'll get that working on the next one. For now, as always, thanks for watching. Catch you next time. Cheers.